Welcome back. This is going to be my second tutorial video for Game of Thrones hair. For Valentine's Day this time, we're going to do Daenerys hairstyle from that one scene where she's eating the horse heart. So, you know, something about eat my heart out Valentine's Day. Yeah, you get it. It's funny. So, I'm going to take some suggestions that you guys gave me from my last YouTube video. And again, just suggest stuff for me. What I should do next, what I'm not doing very well. This is all for you guys, so whatever helps you learn the hairstyle better, that's what we want to do. Okay? Let's get our materials. Again, we want a comb or a hairbrush to smooth out our hair beforehand. On top of that, crap, where'd they go? Oh, here they are. We're going to want at least four, small hair ties like this. There, it focused this time. Cool. And you don't need any bobby pins for this one or big hair ties. So it's a little more difficult than the Catelyn hairstyle that I did last week. But, you know, materials wise, you'd almost need nothing. So, you guys ready? Alright, let's do it. To begin, grab your hairbrush and comb out your hair so that it's smooth and untangled. If you haven't already, part your hair directly down the center. Next, grab equally sized sections of hair from the hairline at your temple. Tie one off with a rubber band to keep it out of the way. With the other one, you're going to make a regular English three-strand braid. Your braid should end in the upper center of the back of your head like I pointed to here, so when you begin your braid, aim it at that spot so that everything will lay flat later. Here I will demonstrate a three-strand braid slowly for anyone who is unfamiliar. Divide your section of hair into three equal parts. Take the leftmost strand and place it over the middle so that it will become the new middle strand. Now take the rightmost strand and place it over the middle strand. Take the left again and place it over the middle. Then the right. Then the left. Right. Left. And continue doing so until you've got a braid long enough to reach past the middle of the back of your head. Dothraki braids should be practical, but are tied with leather, so are never too tight. Likewise, don't make your braids very tight. When you reach where you want your braid to end, tie off with a small elastic. Now do the exact same thing to the hair you tied off earlier on the other side of your head. Remember to aim it at the right spot, in the middle of the upper back of your head. If you have short bangs, I would leave them over your forehead. If you have side swept bangs, you can choose to incorporate them into one of the braids or leave them hanging. Personally, I think they'll look better if you leave them alone, because then the braid won't have ends sticking out and will stay the same thickness. But it can be done either way, so your choice. Layered hair shouldn't be a problem, just try to limit the amount of hair that sticks out of your braids. Wet braiding is a good way to do this if your dry braids end up rather prickly. When your braids are ready, bring them together at the back of your head and secure them with an elastic. This completes the first tier of this hairstyle.
Release the elastics from the ends of your braid so that you can use this hair again later. Now we're going to start the second tier of braids, which is made up of lace braids. Lace braids are a hybrid between English three-strand and French braids. To begin, take a column of hair from your hairline above your ear. Divide it into three strands, and starting with the uppermost strand, do one iteration of braiding, left over middle, right over middle. Now when it's time to do the left strand again, grab another column of free hanging hair and add it to the strand before bringing it over the middle, like in a French braid. With the right hand strand, however, do not add any hair and just braid it normally. Left strand, grab another column and add it in. But braid the right normally. Continue this pattern until you get to the center of the back of your head, at which time revert to a simple three-strand braid to the ends of the hair. Again, do the same thing to the other side of your head. This look relies on symmetry, so remember to start the braid with the strand that is highest on your head. In this case, it's the right strand. It is very important to aim the braid at where you want it to end up the whole time, because that determines how much of the free hanging hair is taken into the braid. Secure these braids together in the center of the back of your head, along with the hanging hair from your first set of braids. Release the elastics from the ends of these braids as well. For the last braid tier, isolate two small sections of hair from your hairline on either side of your spinal column. Bring them forward and turn them into rope braids. If you don't know how to rope braid, refer to my Catlin Tully hair tutorial where I show you more in detail. Just a summary here, divide the hair into two sections, twist the sections in one direction, and then twist those sections together in the other direction. Do this for both strands on either side of your head. As a final step, loosely wrap them around your hair and secure together in the center at around neck height. Don't wrap them so tightly that they constrict the rest of your hair. Loose enough that everything else still hangs rather straight. When you're done with this, release the ends of these braids as well. This is what the finished hairstyle looks like. If you have any questions or comments, just put them in the comment section below and I'll do my best to read them all. Thanks for watching, and remember, if there aren't at least 3 deaths at your Valentine's party, it will be a dull affair. See you later!